Silva, we miss you in there.
Yeah, Silva, you coming to the party?
Oh, no, I'm not. Been to the holiday thing? No, thanks.
On to the holiday thing?
That's silly. Everyone's to the holidays.
You're missing some great food, too. Jacob made vodkas.
Oh,
so
good.
So good.
I've got work to do.
Well, what did she get Santa get you?
She hasn't opened it.
No way.
Open it. I want to see.
You have it, then.
Don't be that way. Open it. See what someone got you.
It's only fair if you're not going to take her.
Yeah.
You leave me alone, okay?
Oh, whoa.
Tell. So then, I want to return it, I guess.
adventure.
A holiday adventure, but with a guarantee.
Guarantee? What kind of guarantee?
I guarantee to melt your heart and change your mind about the holidays.
Or
you can have anything in my shop.
Anything?
Anything. Well, do you have a deal?
Deal.
Deal. Hand me the clock. Let me show you how it works. You see, if you move the clock's hands backwards, it will show you the holidays from the past. And if you move the clock's hands forwards, you'll see the future holidays. But if you hear the bell, it will show you the holidays of today.
It can do all that?
I told you, it was a magical clock. Don't you trust me? Here, nothing like a little demonstration to put one in the right holiday frame of mind.
Woo!
Christmas with the Christmas tree, then we have to do Hanukkah too, not just at my mom's house, but here as well.
Better yet, let's have a Hanukkah party.
That's a great idea. I can make all the food with my mom's recipes. It's gonna be great.
Sorry to hear about your dad.
Thank you, Mr. Schwartz.
I got just the thing to lift your spirits. I'm making matzo ball soup, my mom's killer recipe for brisket, arugula, challah, and chopped liver. And if that's not enough, we'd always sing that awful song about dreidels.
Dreidel, 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 I made it out of clay.
We really need a better Hanukkah song. Seriously. And I made my favorite. Latkes.
Latkes are my favorite too. They're so good with sour cream. No way, applesauce is better.
And we never have to argue about which family we're going to spend the holidays with, for Christmas or Hanukkah.
What are latkes?
Yes, what are they?
Potato cakes!
I've never had that.
You're missing something wonderful! And as our family grew, we kept up the tradition, choosing a new ornament for each kid every year to commemorate something important about the year. Or about them. Baby's first Christmas. Baby's first Christmas number two.
Oh, the year I finally got my dream guitar? That was a good year. Oh, and there's when Sarah was five, and she would only wear pink and only play with Barbie.
Dad.
And there's when Mason was three, and
he was completely obsessed with Buzz Lightyear. Oh, and this one's for Mason's first year of college. And this one, right here. This is from my mother's tree. It was her ornament when she was a little girl. My father gave it to me after she passed. My treasure. It might be a little worse for wear, but I think of her every time I see it on her tree.
We got small menorahs for the kids. And we sing the prayers as we light the candles.
As you can see, a lot of time has passed, and Mason's away at college, new girls are already in high school. We might not see each other as much, but time moves so fast. There's some things that are sacred in our family. It might seem silly, but this tree is one of them. It is so very important to us. Every year we hang the ornaments, and as we take each one out, we laugh and remember our past and all those busy, crazy years when the kids were small. One by one, we fold them out of tissue paper, stop and remember the people and places that are a part of our lives. Memories, all on our
tree. And then we light the menorah, sing the prayers, and sit and watch the candles glow. And remember the miracle of Hanukkah and the miracle of family. And we meet each other. And we remember.
Thank you.
ready to drop dead.
A little. Look about ready to drop dinner.
I got it. As you can see, I got stubborn. And I was visiting my grandparents before coming here. That's why I'm late. They wishes you good health.
Oh, how are they?
They're fine, happy, healthy, celebrating with aunts and uncles. Though you wanted to invite you, actually.
Oh, that's sweet of them, but I...
I know, you're not a big fan of gatherings, I know. But see, you love me, right?
Oh, depends.
Oh, pain! Agony, even! Well, I love you, and as your friend, I chose to sit on the gathering and spend a day with you. So what an imperative trade and everything.
A whole trade?
Mm-hmm.
Just for the two of us?
Yep.
Don't you think it's, you know, too much?
Tomorrow's lunch?
Yeah, that's fair.
So, I got something recently and I thought you'd like it.
Ramen Fury? Are these?
Yeah, want to learn to play it?
Yes!
So, does your culture celebrate anything?
Mm-hmm.
House culture, on holidays.
Oh, no. We don't really have anything. Not one year of the holidays anyway. The only one we get really is New Year, which happens in April.
Oh, wow.
Yep. Far from everyone else's celebration. Christmas in December, New Year's in January, Tet in February, and then there's mine. It's why we don't really do anything this time of year.
Well, now at least I got one more reason to be here and play ramen with you every year.
I was under the impression that Ben had more people to spend his time with. He never really talks about how he spends his holidays at work, but he's always so happy.
Sometimes you don't need your entire family to celebrate the holidays with. It can simply be one other person, and it'll be enough to spread the holiday spirit.
That ramen game does look pretty cute.
Are you considering going to the party and playing with it?
Oh, what? No, just at work during breaks.
Of course. Let's keep watching.
So anyway, how was the Moon Festival? I do this year?
You know, about the same as always. Large family gatherings. You know, your favorite.
Love one.
Right, so. Fried noodles, poke roast, mooncakes. Oh, and my Uncle Broadway's insisted to be premium oolong tea. I thought it was exaggerating, but no, it was pretty good.
Any difference?
Right, you know, I don't think so.
Oh my god. So, did you guys do karaoke?
Yeah, and we got so loud. I think our neighbor might actually hate us now.
Good thing I don't need to hear you sing to feel that way.
Oh, the slander I subject myself to whenever I visit you is unbelievable.
Is it fun though?
If nothing else, I feel much more confident about my own singing voice now.
I can't speak.
You know, I might not get to see them as much as I used to, but it's still nice to see them from time to time. Remind me of how much I love them.
Well, you should. I mean, you still have a chance to.
I'm sorry, I didn't mean to.
No, it's okay. You were just talking. I'm glad. Genuinely, I'm happy to have your family like them.
Yeah. Does Ben not?
That may have been the point, so.
Has he really never tried to reconcile his own family? Where are they?
Well, there are many reasons why people don't get along with their families. Sometimes the ones we love can't see us for who we really are inside.
But isn't he, not at all lonely?
For what it's worth, I think it's better this way. Maybe they're only two people, but it's still someone to share a meal and celebrate with, and the holiday spirit is still there.
Can't I win?
Oh, dude, beginner's luck.
Oh, you only wish you were good as me.
Oh, dude, whatever.
Oh yeah. 20 minutes of school. want to get a 20-minute practice performance after.
Yikes, do you prepare to be a line dancer?
Oh, I can do it 1,000 more times before guitar, but it's probably the only time I'm okay with working out.
Good, because you need all the exercise you can get after you finish all of that.
Yeah.
Why don't you tell me about it?
About line dancing?
Yeah, I want to hear your thoughts. Tell me anything, everything you want. Want to start a history lesson?
Okay, well, how I was taught it, a small village was living their lives in peace. When suddenly they were raided by the bad spirit from the last antagonized people. These types of attacks happen on the regular, so one day they decided not to fight back. They grabbed any household items that might go to scare off the bad spirit. They weren't afraid, but then they started playing a certain rhythm, and suddenly a lion appeared.
Okay.
All right, I'm gonna get the
Oh, Hassan, my brother. How is everything?
Everything is good. Good. And how are you?
Not bad. Not bad at all.
How's your business?
Have you been busy?
You know, business has been a little slow. But I don't know why.
Why? During the holidays it's slow? Why?
Amor, Annette has a bundle of almost $2,000, and the worst part, we have a lot of backstock. Don't sell.
What are you talking about? We sell stuff, just not a lot.
But by giving people what they want, bring them in.
What do they want? They want imported stuff, no?
Yeah, they want imported stuff, but they want rare imported stuff.
So, did it? How's everything on the store?
Oh, you know, just trying to come up with ideas to get sales up. We were so busy today, closed with 9,000 sales.
We only closed out like, what, 7,000?
It was more like 6,000, Bobo.
Close enough. I have ideas on how to make more money. You'll see.
I'm sure you'll get the sales up by New Year's.
Yeah, I mean. So, Maggie. Have you heard from Rose at all? Is she coming home tonight?
I did talk to her last night. I think we get home tonight.
Oh, Montez, I can't wait to see them and hear about their honeymoon trip.
So, Hassan, tell me more about how you make more money.
Hassan, his idea was my idea.
I was thinking about putting in more shelves, bringing new merchandise, you know, put the product right up front.
Well, but that was my idea. We should put the more expensive products up front where everyone can see it. Why should we separate the regular merchandise and have special room for the more expensive products? Plus, we must get rid of the cheap stuff to make room for stuff we actually sell. I'm gonna attempt to get rid of the cheap knockoffs.
Sam, I swear, if you say cheap?
No.
Cheap.
Sam!
Would anyone like some fruit?
Maybe carrying the good stuff is a smart idea. You're in the area.
Oh my.
Bong!
This time, we are somewhere in the future.
After Christmas, the new year has started, and we are in Italy. We are celebrating the celebration, and all celebrations, and they call it the Epiphany.
The, Epiphany?
Yes! And there is one central character that plays an essential role in this celebration.
Oh. Let me guess. Santa Claus. Kids, I moved out.
know? I mean, don't get me wrong, I love our stepfamilies, but it's just like the jigsaw of my family split, and now I'm this puzzle piece that doesn't exactly fit in either picture. Somehow I just got to this place that instead of the guilt of having who to decide who to spend the holidays with, I just rather be alone. And Catherine, and I really want to try latkes with sour cream and applesauce, and I want to dance like Maggie did with her family. It looked like such fun. This evening, I realized that family is who cares for you, not just who you're related to, and it's not about blood bonds, and we don't need to be related to relate to one another. I missed so much not celebrating the Epiphany and Christmas and Hanukkah and friendship. I missed so much, but I want to celebrate it all. Please celebrate with me.
Easily done!
Okay, guys!
Thank you.